Well, of course, this is the Orient Theatre. People have come in their numbers. Boxing fans, young and old, are there in their numbers, as you can see there, celebrating and ready to see one of their own, Nkosinathi Mabere Joyi, in action.
That boy, it's been a privilege. And everybody born being Ghana, the talk on the Kalen, Mabere, a quarter man mass, a casual lens, classically in one.
The pair and a win.
No, it was not a joy in the Kunsegil was out at a long block. Yaya umgain, Kuya in Doba, it's a make or break fight. So, who's the back and the come Balak and Saka can be the man in the Yanyans and about at a long block.
Mabere will win.
Well, I guess that sums it up. Mabere will win. Good evening and welcome to Blow by Blow tonight. Judging from the montage we've seen at the top of the show, hard-hitting boxers, both with incredible knockout ratios. Mabere Joyi up against Florante Condes. Blow by blow. The corner, Mabere Joyi and Florante Condes. Very tough fight. As we say, it's a defining moment for Mabere Joyi. Jan Bergman.
That's
all right. It is definitely a defining moment for Mabere. I mean, he's been knocking them out, but today he comes up against somebody who knows how to knock them out too.
Oh, yes. It's a very good fight for him. It's also very, very good for him to get his opportunity because this is do or die for him. It's either tonight or never.
Make or break, do or die, defining moment, you call it whatever it is, but today Mabere has to show us that indeed he is ready, and he did say that he is ready for this one. This happened a little earlier at the press conference.
Gawin ko lang lahat para mapakita ko sa inyo na
good morning to all. And he's happy that he's here. Now pertaining to the fights, according to him, he respects so much Joyi. He's a good fighter. He's a IBO champion. But according to him, he will give a good fight so that everyone will enjoy the fight this coming Friday.
All right, well, that's Jan, looking at the two boxers themselves. I mean, here we see Mabere Joyi knocking out Gutierrez. Definitely, as we said, their knockout ratios really, really incredible.
Very, very high, Quena, and you can see these guys are very heavy-handed. Both boxers. And tonight is going to be very, very good for each of them to prove who is a better boxer.
And I mean, just looking at that, the reaction that you're seeing there, he did struggle a bit in this fight. And because he's been knocking them out, he did get enough time, you know, to stay in the ring because he won this fight seventh round.
Yes, it was a tough fight for Mabere. But he came through like a champion. And tonight one is really, really going to say where to and what he wants, because what he's destined to be is to be a world champion.
Yanni, has he ever been tested? His chin, do we know? I mean, this guy, look at him. He can knock them out. 20 knockouts out of 23 fights. Mabere, does he have the chin?
Mabere has a very good chin. Very good upper body movement. So he's not an easy target. He's not going to come forward and just unleash punches without moving the upper body effectively and throwing punches of his own. So there's no test for him tonight.
Nkosinathi Joyi, a southpaw IBO champion, knockout ratio is at 78.95. Definitely, he can knock them out.
78 says a big story. So clearly it shows you that whoever is coming in this Florentes boy, they call him the mini Pacquiao. He's gonna get some serious trouble from our homeboy.
Well, a little Pacquiao is Florante Condes, knockout ratio of 71.43, rated number 4, has boxed more rounds than Nkosinathi Joyi, and definitely a tough one for Mabere. Well, the stage is set at the Orient Theater for a big showdown tonight. Mabere Joyi, a defining moment indeed for him. Make or break, we said, the defining moment, but definitely a big fight for Mabere. Let's go straight to the venue now and see if we can catch up with Dumina Mateza. And as you can see, the crowd is singing, happy, ready for Mabere Joyi to take over.
The theater of dreams. And as we prepare for the two boxers to come out into the ring, it is the place where dreams are made. It is the place where dreams are scattered all over the ring. And tonight, no doubt, Mabere has to prove that this is a defining moment for him as he moves away from the IBO to fight for the IBF.
There you go now. I mean, I am right in the dressing room for the former IBO men flyweight champion, Mabere, the South African. Of course, facing the Filipino today, it's going to be a tough one. They are in full song already. And I'm saying that it's crossroads for him, as you know that. Mabere, you're looking at him right now. And of course, as we know, he's no longer now the IBO champion. He has to go through this hurdle in order to fight for the IBF championship. To you, the Duke.
Ladies and gentlemen, coming to you live from East London, it's time for the main event. Tonight is for the IBF World Mini Flyweight Mandatory Eliminator. And now, let's welcome our boxers into the ring. Introducing first, from the Philippines, please put your hands together for Florante.
Single person sitting down at this packed Orient Theater. As we said to you, it is a defining moment for the ex-IBO world champion in the minimum weight division. The guy you're looking at is straight out of the Philippines. His name is Florante Condes, the former IBF world champion. He lost that championship to his opponent of the day, 14th June 2008. His name was Raul Garcia, and of course he lost it on a split decision. For him, he's got to be all focus. He probably just sees Nkosinathi Joyi as an obstacle on his way back to the very top of the world today. So this is an extremely dangerous opponent for Nkosinathi Joyi tonight.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome into the ring his opponent from Ndansani in South Africa. Please put your hands together for the current IBO champion of the world, Nkosinathi Mabere Joyi!
Showtime. Nkosinathi Mabere has been all focused. just watching him warming up for this fight. It's just been so intense. And of course the tension in that dressing room. You've been cut it with a knife. Representing South Africa tonight. And he knows the hopes of his nation all rest on his shoulders. So both these guys, then, both of them left-handed, both of them ex-world champions. I must say that Nkosinathi Joyi did not lose his belt in the ring. He lost it because he's fighting for an opportunity to fight for a world championship that belongs in another sanctioning body. So they're both in the ring right now. Let's take it to the Duke.
Will present the IBF Promoter of the Year 2008 award to Mr. Branko Milenkovic. Congratulations, Branko. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, would you please rise for the Philippine National Anthem? World Victory Eliminator. Tonight's bout is sanctioned by the IBF. The fight supervisor is Louis Preliger from the USA. The ringside positions are Dr. Amanda Zislobo and Dr. Luleki Tama. The official timekeeper is Nongoku Titani. The judges for this bout, all from South Africa, are Dion Duarte, Wally Snowball, and Isaac Shabalala. And when the bell rings, the referee in charge of the action from the USA is Mr. Bill Clancy. And now, ladies and gentlemen, to those in attendance and to the millions of viewers watching around the nation, boxing fans, make some noise! Corner. He weighed in at 47.00 kilograms and is wearing the white and black trunks. He's had 28 professional fights with 23 wins, 4 losses, and 1 draw. He is a former IBF world champion from the Philippines. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Florante. And now, introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. He weighed in at 47.55 kilograms, and he's wearing the red, white, and navy trunks. He is currently undefeated in 19 professional fights. He's fighting out of Mdansani in the sunny South Africa. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting the current
did tell you as he awaited the referee calling the two boxers to the center of the ring.
Received your instructions earlier. 12 rounds. The professionals conduct yourself on the site. I expect a good clean fight. Protect yourself at all times, and gentlemen, you must obey my commands. Punches right here are good. Punches right here are good. Touch gloves. Good luck and God bless.
Well, there you are, referee Bill Clancy, Clancy from the United States of America, of America, from Pittsburgh, North Carolina, in the USA. And I did say earlier, this is the theater of dreams.
Now, these are two youngsters on their way to superstardom, both of them with knockout ratios above 70%. Florante Condes. His knockout ratio sitting at 71%. And Nkosinathi Joyi, in comparison, his knockout ratio is sitting at 78, meaning that close on 8 out of 10 people Nkosinathi Joyi has met have basically kissed the dust. So this is going to be a very, very difficult fight. It's anticipated for the South African Joyi, but I think he can take care of himself.
A big punch to the body. That saga, this man backward. Florante Condes, a man, former IBF champion. A title he won from Muhammad Rahman in Indonesia. Nobody goes, they say nobody goes to Indonesia and comes back with the title.
And that title, he lost it under controversial circumstances, fighting against Muhammad Rahman. You said that?
Well,
he lost it to Raul Garcia. So these two boxers you see in the ring right now are fighting for the right to face Garcia in a world championship bout. But Joyi was the champion in the IBO, same division, of course, then had to drop that championship after showing interest in the IBF minimum weight championship.
Joyi early this round has his man on the back foot. Condes, though, has thrown some punches to the body.
Jonga indlela ababebetha ngaye pads. Baye koneni ka Joyi.
Big punch to the face.
Yes. We're anticipating a devastating right hook from Condes. Both boxers and checkers have amazing right hooks.
Joy's biggest opponent here, toughest opponent, was Sammy Gutierrez, the man who gave him a tough time. And Sammy Gutierrez,
as you can see, Joy now definitely attacking, but he knows he's got to be very careful, very tight, keep that defense very, very tight, stay focused. We saw him early in the first minute, Joy dropping a straight left from far away. And I think that he will be watching that and just measure his distance properly, because if he misses with a drawn out straight left, there's a counter right hook coming.
10 seconds! Well, already Joy has had his man in trouble. Look at that. He's defending that head as it comes to the end of round one.
Welcome back to the Orient Theater. A quick look at the tail of the tape for the two boxers. You can see that the height and reach goes to the South African, and he's the taller of the two. It will seem then that Condes might be the one who wants to fight moving forward and trying to close the distance. As it then, in terms of the boxer statistics, as we look at what might be unfolding as a strategy for each of these two boxers.
Sabambi umjikelo wesibini umjikelo oqala uthande ndoba ufana kaJoy imntwana enkosi yathande ukuthi incotho kancinci apha kule ndodana yase Philippines uFlorante Florante Condes
bafuna ibethe kuqala ijazi abantu bakaJoy bathe funeka ibethe kuqala ijeff ukwenzela into yobana xa egqibezela nge-straight left babe kanti bazikhusele la right hook yalomfana was the Philippines.
Big shots by Condes to get Joy. And Moiso for Florante Condes.
Joy. Joy, if you look at it, wow. You look at the way Condes and Flegas throws a left, rather a right hook on the way in, and then a quick follow up straight left.
Joy is talking to the capacity in full and get a pele la glomfana of Condes.
Joy, I can get a mazan in Fegazi. Needs to go downstairs when you're chopping a tree.
Joy, if you like chop, I jungle over arm right. If you're trying to go up, I send it over arm right.
Yeah, I think they're mostly worried about the right hook, but the over arm right. Mid Mongan Joseph Philippines, the better guy from Checkers.
Oh, nice talk. Ah, better split, BD. And that's who can talk, Condes. Florante Condes, Milo. Amashu Mabini, and a supposo. Pumelela. Amashu Mabini, and a start. Sikumo is a talk of the Condes.
Bandoban is in Flegas, baby, Cheta in the one. Joy, maybe lack of distance per fight might affect him negatively in this fight, but he didn't choose the opponents that he was fighting. But I can tell you now that if you look at the comparison between the two boxers, right now, Joy is looking to close the show.
Alias is worked very quickly on deciding where the distance between himself and his opponent should be, and he's been throwing those punches and hitting his man with precision.
Joy head hunting, probably going to need to go downstairs from time to time. There you go.
Got his man against the ropes.
Joy facing the former IBF strawweight world champion.
10 seconds. Alias is not just another boxer, a former IBF champion in this division. The minimum weight has come to the end of round two. Well, welcome back to ringside. Unfortunately, we'll have to compete with this crowd.
Now, we take a look at Joy just attacking and that is his focus in this fight. You see him hitting straight punches. He's just making sure that he doesn't really shorten the distance between himself and Condes, because in situations like that where Condes is sitting on the ropes, he's looking for a sucker right hook to counter, really. So Joyi, particularly in those situations, has got to stay punching straight and offer angles on the way in so that he's not predictable.
This is only the third time Condes has fought outside of the Philippines. The first time is when he went to Jakarta in Indonesia to win against Muhammad Rahman. The second time when he went to defend in Mexico. He had an opportunity not to go to Mexico, but he decided to go to Mexico and fought Raul Garcia at Estadio Arturo La Paz. And he lost his title there. Condes trying to throw a punch at Judge Upayao. Got it. Good Condes combinations.
Condes has been in six championship bouts, two of which were world titles. On the other hand, Mabere Joyi has been in 11 championship fights, four of which were world title fights. So at world title level and at championship level, Mabere is definitely more experienced.
Well, yes, I did say it's not just another boxer. This one is rated number 8 by the IBO, 9 by the WBC, 3 by the WBO, and 5 by the WBA, and is the former IBF champion. Something's wrong there.
He got hit by a straight left to the hip. Wow.
Oh, did you see that?
Yeah, definitely. Joyi's right hook and clegas is one of the most dangerous punches you're ever going to see in any boxing ring. So a referee just telling the boxers to keep it up, keep those punches up.
Well, I did tell you, Joyi, on the other hand, is ranked 7th by the WBC, 6th by the WBA, 11th by the WBO, and was the IBO champion, problem still is, and 3rd by the IBF. Well, Condes slipped in his corner there, but Joyi takes advantage of that. Good combination to the air. Good punches from Joyi.
You see, Joyi Mtlegas, it's the second time that whenever Condes is on the ropes, he only hits straight punches. You see him, doesn't shorten the distance at all because he knows there's a counter right hook. They have prepared very well for it because they know Condes' right hook is incredible as well.
Well, let's see what the ref says. It declares that a low blow and give Condes opportunity to rest. He has 5 minutes to rest if he wants to.
How much time?
There you go. Now let's take a look at what happened there. Straight left downstairs, and unfortunately, that was definitely accidental. Joyi is not a dirty fighter. We know that.
Walk it off. Walk it off. Walk
it off. So they're telling him to walk a little bit.
Well, you can see the experience of the referee, Bill Clancy. 25
accidental.
Years as a professional
accidental,
boxing referee,
accidental.
Has refereed for the IBC,
accidental.
WBC, IBO, WBO, and has refereed in fights that involve Mike Tyson, Larry Holmes, Manny Pacquiao, Jermaine Taylor, Greg Page. You know many of those names, Mr. Luna.
Yes, definitely. And you see him just by the way he's taking control of what's going on in the ring right now. Has told the officials at ringside that it was not intentional, it was accidental. So, therefore then, there would not be any disqualification.
10 seconds!
10 seconds in this round. Let's go.
Left hand, this state left side, counter to the WBC, ilandele uphinde ubuye uphinde ubekho ungubekile ngosana aka umbetanga blova ungubekile yebo so siyeka ubethe dikibodi and keep that tap ihamba left ihamba yebo that tap nena okay
nice and clean okay
masabambe kulo mjikelo
nyanzele mhlekazi mastolike kulanje ngithethwe koneni
oh
kastolika unik gerand uthi kaunto faco falo mfana umbethe nge straight left sako kandi umqedeshi wakhe uthi haa ungayeki ukwehla ubethe imbambezi
because of what happened because that was accidental but it mustn't change the strategy that's what he means
well yes the referee emphasized that at the end of that round was accidental no points taken
right hook from Condes countered by a straight left from Joy
and you'd be surprised that the pace comes from Joy more than Condes
this is a classic battle here straight left versus right hook there you go
big punch from Condes another all. Big punch from Condes
ila overarm left kuthetha ngayo mhlekazi ubethe kabini nanga ufuna iphinda kwakhona
you've got to watch out for that Joy has got to, in order for that overarm to not find Joy he's got to keep busy with the right hand
well he's been accepting those punches to the forehand big punch again from Condes
Condes has decided not to go hunting the right hook because he's decided in this particular round that the left hand is going to work for him
look at that combination from Joy wrist punches from Joy pushes his man to that corner Joy landing those blows very hard this man in the corner a flashing rock left hook but did not land
right hook from the outside
yes from the outside overarm jab left now in action again
Condes has not taken any round yet
well he's been beaten to the punch on many occasions
well Joy is making the fight happen and he's not waiting for Condes to come at him
thing is that Joy not really opening up he's making Condes miss right in front of him under 10 seconds to go in round 4 this already scored for Nkosinathi Joyi at the moment
Zamkele Ntambo silapha kanye e Orient Theatre apho obathewatsho omnye umuntu ingathi ukhawu kunobathana namhlanje
Watchoga man Mhlekazi Joy hitting a right hook on the way out but it just shows you how good his timing is how well prepared he is for this particular fight and we are looking to see if Condes Mhlekazi will deliver on the reputation because we know that he definitely can fight he didn't come here to just be another boxer who's going to take a punch and go home and say thank you for the payment He wants to get back to the top of the world and become a world champion again.
No doubt he has a man in his corner in Ortiz Dante, a man from Puerto Rico, originally from Puerto Rico, based in Texas in the United States of America. He's his manager and now he doubles up as a trainer today as Condes his trainer to go back home to the Philippines. I like Joy's pace. I like his timing. Condes is trying from the outside. Big punch. Driven back into that corner.
Betty Jeppe Mazanzu Joy. Kanye up his bindin. But really keeping those punches crisp and short when he's at close quarters.
Keeping his man very busy. Yazama lunging forward. Oh, Fana was the Philippines. Got out Tibetan Empire's tutor. Taufika, Ufika, Sazinga.
Amanda Leo Mabi in Ilan Chagasi. That left is a right hook that's missed Joyi there. Still very dangerous. Joyi has got to keep his left hand up.
And Joyi really hitting this man with every punch in the book.
Is still very dangerous, Condes and Figures. Very, very dangerous.
Oh! A punch!
Headbutt.
Let me see.
Alright, definitely clash of heads there. So, we are beyond round number five.
On an eye that was already bleeding.
We're beyond round number five. This is a world title fight.
Accidental.
Yes, the referee gets it right and calls it an accidental headbutt. And take a look at that.
The cut below the eye is going to punch. He got hit real hard here.
It's below the eye.
And the other thing, which it's, I hope...
Not too bad.
I hope our referees are learning from this referee. We saw him immediately after the bell goes for the 10 seconds.
Okay.
He stands very close to the two boxers. As soon as the bell goes for the end of the round, he steps in.
Got your head.
All right, we're back in action then. Just Joyi getting told to watch his head there, but again, we do know that was definitely accidental, and the referee getting it right. Joyi will be looking to close the show.
Oh, big punch in the face. It is a hand speed from Joyi. Driving his man around the ring.
Daga Joyi from the Bezel of Chagazi.
Yabon from the Bezel. What do I need to say? I'm not going to go like that. I said, me, Nathan, do you cook?
10 seconds.
Let's go.
Lila and Timbi will pull him together once again. And
watch his head. Watch his head.
When he said 10 seconds.
Okay. You okay?
Welcome back.
You okay? Okay.
The Orient Theater is packed to capacity. And take a look at that. Joyi, although there was an accidental headbutt there.
Let's go!
You can see that was a very dominant performance.
Let's feed them up again in this round. Nkosinathi Joyi comfortably ahead. And one would like to see whether that corner is able to keep that cut from opening up again.
They're very experienced. It looks like they've done a good job already. So look at the way that Joyi knows. Joyi, passes straight left. On the way in. He can't get comfortable. This is still a very, very dangerous opponent.
He's very dangerous. Has him on the ropes. Once again, he's taken some good punches. Condes.
The last round could have even been scored 10-8, just by how dominant Nkosinathi Joyi was. Joyi is still drawing that left hand from the outside from time to time when he actually intends to throw a short punch.
It is in close quarters where this man is dangerous.
Joyi mane so lula kancinci abethe straight left mhlekazi aslock. That is why he's such a devastating puncher.
Well, yes, he's dominated this fight completely tonight. Ebonisa ngokumhlophe ndoba sekulungele ndoba ayishiye lentshinga ye IBO akanyathelele phezulu
angene ku IBF mhlekazi
angene ku IBF umjoke eyiqhuba kunyana sithonga naye ngokunokwakhe njalo wayibusela umvaba ngamuyisela kula kona oku kodwa yabuya le ndoda
womelele ngokungumangaliso lo mfana mhlekazi wasephilippines
uyanyamezela umkhabi yaye unendwa une-shock punch ayiphosayo.
Good thing is Joyi is pacing himself.
Joyi uyamotha umkabu menzi mbawula elapha phezu kwakhe.
Joyi had a very difficult fight against Gutierrez last year, but I wouldn't say he's having the same amount of difficulty here. I mean, but Condes coming into this fight obviously had a much bigger reputation than Gutierrez.
No doubt, he did beat Trejo as we come to the end of round six.
Right, let's take a look at some of the highlights. Amakabanjinjwa mjigalas pumaguo with Tandatu. Joyi just being very businesslike, quite economical as well with his punches. But you can see that he's been incredibly dominant in this fight, taking all of those punches and taking all of those rounds. Joyi has not lost a round thus far. So looking to be focused. Let's get into the corner and see what they say.
Okay.
Let's go. Blue corner. Wipe it up good. Wipe it up good. Let's go.
Jikela kwesixhenxe ngoku esingena kuwo kulo mlwe IBF eliminator besilela bezawucela umngeni umfana kaGarcia Raul Garcia Hilares wase Mexico. Akakho number one no number two PIPF kolutiti. Kone enye la matote izawungena ku number one enye ingene ku number two okanye ihle kunyukiswe enye yala asezantsi. Ize le ingu number one ke icele umngeni ku Raul Garcia.
Let's call some mhlekazi into oyithethayo uthi abafana sibajongileyo balwela ilungelo lokuba bacele umngeni ku Raul Garcia.
Kunjalo ka
umlo wabo ophumeleleyo apho umlo wakhe olandelayo ngowenjinga yehlabathi
kuyafunaka eMexico
utsho mhlekazi
ngoba uRaul Garcia akasozeze apha uyathi hayi mayize apha le ndoda yiyo ifritat la ndima kodwa ke uyakwazi unamaqhinga kakhulu umthelekisi wale ntwana inguJoyi uBranko Milenkovic. Morning, Joyi's talk is if this bugala is salayo. Lendotana. Oko koko kali le lom lokum jikeloka. Ibe woya uposa is tonga is vayo. E trinezela kun janji ngokodwa.
Ute kwaka mshika se Orient and the Abba. Teta ndo na londo uvela kwati kwaka lom jikelo stanka.
Jabona ba inzwa inyeloba. Mjikelo nga amnye. Iba sesezo.
Top class boxing on SABC Sport tonight.
Well, as we are into the seventh round of this fight, sad story. The world woke up this morning to the death of music icon Michael Jackson. Joyi following his man around the ring, really being dominant here. It's a matter of time. If Joyi is able to keep his man on the ropes and he does not return any fire, the referee might step in. But you still see some flashes of brilliance from this man.
No, definitely. You look at the way he throws the right hook from a very awkward position, and he still finds a target.
He's come to the end of that round.
Good job.
Welcome back to ringside for the start of round number 8. Nkosinathi Joyi walking straight past his man. Great deal of friendship in this match, Steve. Never seen that. Boxers shaking hands, getting the gloves to meet each other before the end of the round, and the one walks past the other. And then they start fighting.
It shows they're both gentlemen, doesn't it?
Yes. Condes, his face is deformed. It's not the same face we saw as he came into the ring. Joyi hardly any changes in his face. Lushika ungabi yazamkela isidonga.
Udinaba kumhlekazi dinoko. Buso balo mfana phesheya. Umane bulungiswa. Ebu akota lo mfana ka Joyi.
What was that all about?
I think if you see, I don't know if Joyi has a fever blister just above his upper lip.
Well, yes.
That's definitely not a punch. That's caused that. He had that before he came into the ring.
Yes, at the press conference, one of the journalists did ask, what was this? Oh, he hits his man backwards. Big punch from Joyi. What's the clean?
Joyi going downstairs, he knows he can finish, but Condes still very dangerous. He looked at the counter right hooks. Watch out for that. Desperate punches from Condes. I mean, you can't throw a left uppercut from that angle at all.
Well, Joyi fought a man called Gabriel Puma on his record. That man is called, his name is Boom Boom Joyi, at the Centenary Hall in Port Elizabeth. Joyi really comes forward now. Wants to end this fight within the distance. I spoke about round number 11.
Well, with few rounds away from that right now, but it looks like he could finish this off with 28 seconds to go to the end of round 8.
The interesting thing here for Joyi is that he has Mpulampula in his corner, always Nick Durant in his corner. 10 seconds.
I think that's to be commended, really. So Afghan boxing trainers putting egos aside and saying, look, this is the most important fight of Joyi's life, and therefore let's collaborate.
Okay. Good job. Okay.
Some of the highlights from the previous rounds. Joyi getting caught by a counter straight left. Look at that. Even when Condes is trying to throw a right hook, his favorite weapon, it's just completely useless at the moment. But he is still very dangerous, very dominant. Performance by Joyi. That one, round number 8. Let's go, round 9.
Soba Mimchigelo et al. Bangoku Ingati. Goltan Dainukba. Indoja is Gatli Sekule Michigelo Kvela. Indoba Iklungelo Kula Michigelo Elishmel Nambini. Jongala left cross ephuma kula ndodana.
Right cross.
Right, njalo kanye umuntu aziyo le nto lomfana ukandithi.
Amanqala ayibhida mhlekazi.
Ah, ndibhida manje.
Abafana ngathi ngonongala.
Ewe. Wathi nongala kubantwana kutheni ihamba ngolu hlobo. Bathi hayi sibona kuwe mama. Kutheni ihamba ngecala, hayi sibona kuwe mama.
Abafana ke badala loo nto mhlekazi xa bengamanqele noba bamane bejinela kweli cala lirongo.
Ewe. Sithonke sivayo esiphela kufana. Oh, combination ngajamgqibezela, hayi uye uthi uyaphela ungabi, hayi asuke umame ngenyawo khona mxina ekoneni wabuya ungabi sikuboye sasithonga.
Battle of right hooks and checkers in this fight. Look at that. Condes still in this fight.
Well, Condes is fighting very well, but he needs to sustain that. He needs to sustain that. Mabere has never enjoyed himself as he does here.
Good right hook to the body from Condes. These were the combinations they were hitting back at the gym. They've prepared for this in Texas.
There are those surprise lunges from this man, Condes. Lunges forward surprisingly. As Joy now controls the center. Oh, big punch from Condes. Again, another low blow.
He pulled him down.
Oh, he pulled him down.
You cannot pull him down, blow. That's why he hit you low. I
thought. He's going to give him another 5 minutes. It's up to him where he wants to take
down.
The 5 minutes.
Pull him down, that's why he hit you low. Okay?
This
you
referee is amazing. Walk look at off, that, look off, at that. He can see that the fault was actually with Condes, and hence the mistake from Joy. Condes pulled Joy down. Yeah. This referee, this is refreshing.
Well, I was saying,
walk around.
It's refreshing,
walk.
Really.
I looked at the way he does, his
concentration is amazing.
Take your time.
The reason Condes got hit by an illegal punch is that he had pulled his opponent Joy down.
Yes, that was Ortiz Dante you saw there for a minute. And as they continue with round number 9, scheduled for 12.
Boxing is contact sport, scientific as it can be sometimes, but you got to protect yourself at all times.
That's about the first thing you learn when you're a boxer.
That's what the referee tells you
at the beginning of the fight. Oh, another big punch from Condes.
Good right hook from Condes.
Well, those have been fine. Few in between. As it comes to the end.
He pulled him down. That's why he got hit low. He pulled him behind the head. Okay?
So, the visitor, Florante Condes, former IBF strawweight champion, has not won a single round in this fight. Not a single round. In actual fact, if the judges scored round number 5 and round number 10, 10-8, I would not blame them. That's just how dominant Nkosinathi Joyi has been.
Well, I don't know whether you've had an opportunity to eat some meat with Nkosinathi Joyi. You can eat real meat.
It's a positioning thing. Look at where Joy plants his front foot. They were preparing for a dangerous right hook from Condes. Condes, since the right hook has been neutralized, does not have a game plan.
Another big punch from Joy. Condes comes short. His face has been completely deformed. Or should one say rearranged?
I like rearranged.
Watch your head, watch your
Jigelo kweshume sikuwo ngoku nazi za combination ezivela ku Joy ayiqina le ndodana enters dungeon iphaya ayintim jenzeni kuyaliwa. Referee is not over anxious, he's never jumped in, he kept his distance and only comes closer at the last 10 seconds so that he can stop the boxer from hitting after the bell.
The final figure is I can't get a right hook. Joy, as he drops a straight left downstairs, the opportunity for a counter right hook is there. So that's why Ubanga Bubugelu Sekai, Umkambu, Nembuzo, Eti, Utena, Akabezelu Joy, Urai, Gledenza, and Shaka.
Yafuneka and Obin Dota, Iambe, 12 rounds.
Apart from that, it would be very dangerous to be callous against such an opponent.
Well, he has no doubt. I think Nick Durant in the corner will be very much aware of that if you remember the Silence Mabuza fight in Springs.
Better way right hook. Nance is in the right hook.
Corner.
They're telling Joy to keep his guards up because four right hooks have landed in a row against him.
Very dangerous opponent, this man. When you think he's down and out, he comes back with a vengeance. While Joy has his man against the ropes on the far side.
Joy just threw a straight left from outside and he missed.
10 seconds! Stop at the bell!
Best round for Condes by far. Moscomgele at Orient Theatre. East London, the Mecca of boxing. Condes will never forget this venue. There's been vuvuzelas in the crowd.
What is that? Seconds out!
There you go,
seconds,
let's go.
Seconds out! Wipe me up good, Nick! Wipe me up good, please!
At close quarters.
Seconds out, let's go! Let's go!
Joy,
go, okay?
Taking his time. But four right hooks from Condes landed, raising some concern around ringside in Chagazi. All the different trainers from the Eastern Cape were saying exactly the same thing. Keep it tight. Keep your guards up. Because they can see that right hook is still very dangerous.
Well, Condes is still very much in this fight. And he might not be in this fight in terms of points, but surely he's still there in terms of physical being.
In actual fact, Condes can win all these rounds now. He'll never win this fight. So, which means Joy definitely has to be careful. It doesn't mean he necessarily has to take the foot off the pedal, but maybe a change.
Stay
a little
out of
bit
trouble.
Of a switch in strategy.
Gotta stay out of trouble. This morning, as a gloves got Joy is motion Nick Durant. Also, Nick Durant pair of open gloves will have job. Joy, that you from Pumla, Colom Jigelo, Shimi, El Nani.
All right, Pumla, Pumla, Baya Funa. He's won the first 10 rounds, 10-0. So at the end of round 10, the scorecard would have been 100.
The penultimate round in this fight, round number 11.
100 for Joy, 90 for Condes.
What a gap. You can't make up 10 points in two rounds.
In actual fact, if you were generous, you could give Joy extra points for round 5 and round number 8.
Now the man who's been keeping score here, Dixie Mula, knows what he's talking about.
Kandi, overarm left. Joyi Mhlekazi.
Always Condes is trying to look for an opportunity to throw caution to the wind. There you are. He has nothing to lose. He has lost this fight already if it goes the distance. But he will try every opportunity to throw some shocking punches from awkward angles.
10 seconds.
10 seconds in this round. That's the end of round 11.
There you go then. Ujonge nje sikubethela ngonyawo lono wabo umfana kwaJoyi senzela into yakhe
eska itheko. What is up? Second down. Let's go.
Bill Clancy. The final round, round number 12. Championship bout.
Let's go.
Florante Condes versus Nkosinathi Joyi. It is for the IBF minimum, if you like, strawweight world championship. Elimination this. Who wins here, whoever wins here, faces the world champion next.
Raul Garcia Hilaris from Mexico. Well, at the final round here, Joyi has to be very careful.
What do you think, Nick?
What do you remember? Silence Mabuza.
Eh. Ate winile abetwe. Ijab umjikele ukuthebela.
Yeah.
Talent to be chat.
Talent to be chat. Masibone.
Wants to throw caution to the wind. The good thing is that Joyi is not giving an impression that he's fighting on the back foot. He's offering more angles in this fight, making sure that Condes
tackles his man and knocks him down.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7
in the middle.
You okay?
We are aim out Condes. That's all.
No doubt, if this fight ends, it will put the matter beyond doubt.
10-8, round 12. Further 2 points deficit.
Gotta stay out of trouble. As the seconds are ticking away, the minutes are ticking away.
And so Joyi,
man.
Joyi betray Rayito Mhlekazi eslevi. Those people who said his chin is suspect, I don't quite know what they were talking about.
Well, yes, Condes trying to find an opening. He's changed his tactics completely.
Joyi just has to do this until the end of the round. It's just 39 seconds.
Stay out of trouble. It is the alertness. It is the timing that Joyi has. Tonga is sick of Moya. He's the Zona Jenge, PSLAO. Pele Lomlo.
10 seconds. That's it then.
Great fight.
Clinical
great fight.
Performance.
Great fight. Thank you, my friend. Thank you.
Welcome back to the Orient Theatre. A quick look at what happened in this fight. Right hook from
Joyi. Condes finds himself on the canvas. This actually was the final round, which would have been scored 10-8. Apart from that, Condes, really dangerous as he was, didn't really pressure Joyi at all. We didn't get to see Joyi get into trouble, but they prepared very well for him. Joyi properly choreographed for this fight. A few incidents, if you can see there, Joyi unfortunately going downstairs, finding the target, illegal punch thrown, but obviously not intentional at all. But Bill Clancy as a referee must be one of the best I have seen. Dominant performance and clinical performance from the South African former IBO world champion. It looks like Duke is now ready. So we are going to take you to the Duke for the final results.
Ladies and gentlemen, this mandatory eliminator was scheduled for 12 rounds. It made it to the final bell. Let's give both of these boxers a big round of applause. Here at the Orient Theater in East London, the judges have reached a decision, and we now go to the scorecard. Judge Snowball scores about 120 to 107. Judge Florante scores this bout 120 to 107. And Judge Shabalala scores this bout 119 to 108. To the winner by unanimous decision and the new IBF World Mini Flyweight Mandatory Challenger.
Yes, the South African winning there. My scorecard was exactly 120-107 as well, considering the two points deficit in the final round, round number 10. Other than that, a very dominant performance. Very, very dominant performance from Nkosinathi Joyi. We're now waiting for Dumela Bateza in the ring. Standing by for an interview with the two boxers. So then, this little man called Florante Condes, mini Pac-Man, unfortunately coming short. We didn't get to see what he was all about. Completely neutralized by Nkosinathi Joyi. We're going to leave it at that at ringside, and let me take you to Dumela Bateza in the ring.
Welcome you all. We're trying to find Mabere. You better come around. They'll have to wait before they talk to you. Daga, Daga Joyi, Tibode Ulila, Inyembezi, Gabazazofuya.
Well, Matthias, I'm Dingacho, and it is Inyembezi Zofuya. Because Tibone Lele, Nogotua, Kao Siya Kutaitile, and our first Gwenya Taitile, Kubanzin. Usisela namhlanje ngifuna ukuxoxa ngentinyana yokunzima kakhulu. Into endincedileyo yitraining nefitness noBoy Boy Mbulambula noNick Durandi noViva Sabatana noNcedo Cetane abantu bebendiphethe. So ndibulela kakhulu apha ngakubo.
Abantu abaninzi bebenoloyiko lokuba le ndodana inamandla angumangaliso kodwa ingathi wena ubenakho ukuyineutralize.
Ngokwenyani kunyanisiwe yayo inawo amandla because bendiva kwezinye irawundi but ndizixelele uba liqhina eli because ngoku ndifuna i-IBF WBC WBO WBA so ndinyuke iqhina ke ngoku so Lomfana ndiyamvuma is a boxer, is a puncher, but now is a boxer, is a puncher. So na ikhaba ntanyamezela nakanjani na.
Nkosinathi sifuyisana nawe makasive ngaba uBranko uthi uza kusaphi na.
Akagqibela ngifuna ukuthi namhlanje elibisenzeka lo mlobe lumela abantu basemayirheni kwindawo ensuka kuyo nzalwa kuyo eTranskei. So ngifuna ukuthi namhlanje wonke umuntu ongumyirha uzondi uthambo lonyaka uhlabela umzondayo namhlanje makazazi ukuthi unomntana onguNkosinathi Joyi and siseza yaphambili emayirheni. Enkosi.
Nkosinathi Joyi lowo imini yakhe funa simnikela joba Branko. Now the his next opponent, if he wants the IBF title, is a fight Raul Garcia Hilaris.
Oh, that is correct. There is some time frame, 9 months for the champion to make mandatory. We are properly looking early in the new year, February, and I'm going to put my head on the block. I'm going to bring Garcia here to East London.
Won't be easy to bring Garcia here.
Won't be easy, but I deliver as always.
So Branko, once again, want to congratulate you for winning the IBF International Promoter of the Year.
It is IBF Promoter of the Year award. It's a great achievement for me, but even it's bigger recognition for South Africa, because this is the first time ever African promoter gets such award.
Branko, thank you very much. And that was Branko Milenkovic, the promoter here, promoting Nkosinathi Joyi for this eliminator for the IBF title, as we take you back to the studio in Johannesburg.
Thank you very much, Dumile Mateza. Yanni, just looking at that. It is definitely a defining moment for Mabere. I mean, he's been knocking them out, but today he comes up against somebody who knows how to knock them out too.
Oh yes, it's a very good fight for him. It's also very, very good for him to get his opportunity, because this is do or die for him. It's either tonight or never.
Make or break, do or die, defining moment, you call it whatever it is, but today Mabere has to show us that he is ready, and he did say that he is ready for this one. This happened a little earlier at the press conference.
Le weekend labe ngilo mkhulu kum kunelweni banendilo kuyilwa okunifinelele ndifikelele kwimanaba yokhulu songoku into ngoku ixhomekeke kum ukuthi ezibonakalise ukuthi ndingumabhere manyane na cause ngokunokwam xa sendethe ifight ndizayiwina nge-knockout noba kweyiphi na i-round.
Dumile Mateza, and as you can see, the crowd is singing happy, ready for Mabere Joyi to take over.
This is the Orient Theater, the theater of dreams. And as we prepare for the two boxers to come out into the ring, it is the place where dreams are made. It is the place where dreams are scattered all over the ring. And tonight, no doubt, Mabere has to prove that this is a defining moment for him as he moves away from the IBO to fight for the IBF.
There you go now. I mean, I am right in the dressing room for the former IBO mini flyweight champion, Mabere, the South African. Of course, facing the Filipino today, it's going to be a tough one. They are in full song already. And I'm saying that it's crossroads for him, as you know that. Mabere, you're looking at him right now. And of course, as we know, he's no longer now the IBO champion. He has to go through this hurdle in order to fight for the IBF championship. To you, the Duke.
Ladies and gentlemen, coming to you live from East London, it's time for the main event. Tonight is for the IBF World Mini Flyweight Mandatory Eliminator. And now, let's welcome our...
Well, of course, this is the Orient Theatre. People have come in their numbers. Boxing fans, young and old, are there in their numbers, as you can see there, celebrating and ready to see one of their own, Nkosinathi Mabere Joyi, in action.
That boy, Better privilege, no, we like some of them, they born. And everybody born being a Ghana, the talk on the Colin, the Mapper, a Cotaman Mass, a Casosa Lens, Classalia in one.
The pair and a win. No, it was not joy in the Kunsekil without Tata Lomlo. Yaya Umgeni, Kuya in Doba, it's a make or break fight. So, who's the back and the Kamala can Sakakam be the man in the Yanyans and about Tata Lomlo?
Mapper will win.
Well, I guess that sums it up. Mabere will win. Good evening and welcome to Blow by Blow tonight. Judging from the montage we've seen at the top of the show, hard-hitting boxers, both with incredible knockout ratios. Mabere Joyi up against Florante Condes. Blow by Blow. The corner Mabere Joyi and Florante Condes. A very tough fight. As we say, it's a defining moment for Mabere Joyi. Jan Bergman.
Good morning to all. And he's happy that he's here. Now pertaining to the fights, according to him, he respects so much Joyi. He's a good fighter. He's a IBO champion. But according to him, he will give a good fight so that everyone will enjoy the fight this coming Friday.
All right, well, that's Jan, looking at the two boxers themselves. I mean, here we see Mabere Joyi knocking out Gutierrez. Definitely, as we said, their knockout ratios really, really incredible.
Very, very high, Quena, and you can see these guys are very heavy-handed, both boxers. And tonight is going to be very, very good for each of them to prove who is a better boxer.
And I mean, just looking at that, the reaction that you're seeing there, he did struggle a bit in this fight. And because he's been knocking them out, he did get enough time, you know, to stay in the ring because he won this fight seventh round.
Yes, it was a tough fight for Mabere, but he came through like a champion. And tonight one is really, really going to say where to and what he wants, because what he's destined to be is to be a world champion.
Yanni, has he ever been tested? His chin, do we know? I mean, this guy, look at him. He can knock them out. 20 knockouts out of 23 fights. Mabere, does he have the chin?
Mabere has a very good chin. Very good upper body movement. So he's not an easy target. He's not going to come forward and just unleash punches without moving the upper body effectively and throwing punches of his own. So there's no test for him tonight.
Nkosinathi Joyi, a southpaw IBO champion, knockout ratio is at 78.95. Definitely, he can knock them out.
78 says a big story. So clearly it shows you that whoever is coming in this Florentes boy, they call him the mini Pacquiao. He's gonna get some serious trouble from our own boy.
Well, a little Pacquiao is Florante Condes, knockout ratio of 71.43, rated number 4, has boxed more rounds than Nkosinathi Joyi, and definitely a tough one for Mabere. Well, the stage is set at the Orient Theater for a big showdown tonight. Mabere Joyi, a defining moment indeed for him. Make or break, we said, the defining moment, but definitely a big fight for Mabere. Let's go straight to the venue now and see if we can catch up with the...